Tá, pronto. Horizontal, seu câmera, horizontal, outra direção. Wow, this is really stiff. Sim, it's a flipper. The Brian Tighe Compact Fighter. The button lock works fine. No, well, a little bit of up and
Oh.
down play, I think, which is common in button locks, which is why I think they're not. Pretty stiff detent. So this, okay, I guess it kind of flicks out. Oh, it's really hard to underflick it. Now, here's the question. So that's where the things go. You see, it's sort of milled into the G10 or whatever this is. So I thought, well, and it curves around this way. I thought maybe you could flip it, but it's curved in this direction, see? So I thought, well, flip it over, right? There's CRKT printed on the other side. But look at that. Doesn't work. See? So I tried bending it back. You can see all the little marks. You can kind of see by the glinting, there's a slight curve in it. See? You can barely see it. Anyway, so that's a big fail. I tried a bunch of different times. I just couldn't get it to bend over, and so I bend over. Anyway, I'm just gonna have to switch it back. This is gonna have to be an always right-handed knife. So I was hoping that all of my ambidextrous, I could make left-handed knives for my left-handed pocket. Anyway, so there's that story. I'll maybe do revisit that at some point, but that was a great big fail. I'm doing an unboxing of Mission 67 Battle Box. First and only Battle Box. I won this in a big giveaway that he sponsored live. Video Addict, he did something like five giveaways, and they did it live, and I jumped in on the live late. I was like, "Hey, what'd I miss?" Kind of sarcastically, and the chat just blew up. They're like, "Dude, you won!" I thought people were just messing with me, and sure enough, he chimes in. He's like, "Yo, Hollywood!" He's like, "You won!" And I won my second favorite one. I think there was one that had a Condor axe, but this one has the Rev. Nezmuk. So here's Battle Box 67. Eu ganhei o sorteio. So Mission 67 Survival Key. The basic Battle Tac concealment holster, grenade soap, Southern Sword glow in the dark reflective paracord. Oh, I'm stoked. Well, actually, this is my favorite box because I wanted that the most, even though it's just a small little thing. Biofilm Defender. Oh yeah, that's for to prevent algae, I think. Pure polish and heirloom vegetable seed. There we go. I did want that. Oh, this is my favorite one. Solo stove light. Oh my gosh, this is actually my favorite one. And that's their new show that they've got going on. So, solo stove. And you know, you can watch unboxing of these. I'm not gonna do an extensive unboxing. So solo stove. This is the MK2, the grenade soap. I don't see what the brawny fragrance of pure rawhide. Oh, wow. Oh, wow. That's not nice. Does smell like rawhide, but a little too soapy, though. Free test kit, Biofilm Defender, treats 230 gallons, treats water up to 5 years. Wow. Reduces the risk of biofilm bacteria breaking loose and contaminating store water. Look at that. 330 gallons. How big is that? Because I once lived with a guy who had one of those things in the backyard. I mean, it was enormous. Heirloom vegetable kit, 40 seed packets. That's pretty exciting, and it's sealed. I mean, I almost don't want to open it because this is really meant for like emergency. It's almost worth it just to keep in case of emergency. So, Grenade Soap Company. What is this? Is this a microfiber? Oh yeah! Wow! No kidding. Now that is a high-end microfiber towel. Oh, it's a full-length towel. It's got the mesh so it can dry out on its own, and you can kind of store it back. So that's pretty cool. No real carabiner. So in order to carry this, attach it to your pack. You might have to do it with this, but in that case it can open. So I'm not sure how the best way to pack that is. Stoked on that. 7-strand, actual 550. Oh, it's from their company as well. 550 paracord. So I'm really thrilled about this. I realize I could buy this on my own for not much, but you know, just I literally haven't even bought 550 yet, just because, you know, just a little bits of it laying around everywhere. And then finally, this concealed instructions for assembly under the desk holster. Oh, right. So you pin that under the desk, and then you can fit your piece right under there. So it's basically just plastic, but it's kind of heavy. So I guess I'm sure it's designed to be pretty sturdy. You know, who knows how long that elastic will last. Oi, isso. Isso é pra dentro, embaixo da uma mesa, e isso é pra Taurus.
Guarda-chave.
Isso.
Ah, tá, como...
Pra pistola. Entendeu? Pra esconder. Isso. É legal, né? Carro? Não, difícil para carro. Talvez. She's saying you could do this in your car too, but I think it's meant for under the table. I mean, because it's flat. I don't see if you can get that much of a flat space. This, I thought was plastic. It's kind of rubbery too. See, it's got a lot of flex. So, I mean, maybe you could almost flex it onto a car console. Pin it in, drill it in or something. Although that would make it tough. This is actually pretty high quality elastic. As you can see, they double stitched it there, so that might be pretty good stuff here. So, you know, I'll look at that later. Battle tack. Looks like it came with a sticker, so that's cool. I'll use that sticker. Came with the screws, so I'm gonna put that back so I don't lose it. Although I will use that sticker. Okay. And last but not least, you know, this is the big show stealer. Ooh, Revo sticker, cool. I'll use that. Here it is. Here's the NES book. A lot of people like this. Great flipping action. Liner lock, about 50%.
Okay.
Gostou?
Oh, boa ação. Olha a lâmina dela.
Gostei. Isso. É muito único, né? This is named for Mr. Nesmuk, who's like a OG kind of OG bushcrafter, and this is his blade shape, or what they think was his blade shape. Not in a folder. It's very unusual to see this in a folder. However, the thing is, I thought it was best based on some sort of Native American design, but that might not be the case. I thought so, but not sure. Fala!
O design do cabo também, conforto, segurança também, de manuseio.
Ah, isso.
Também. Não, assim, eu gostei do design dela, entendeu?
Yeah, she really likes this design. And she's saying that the handle, it looks very secure, which is true. It's a fantastic, look at the way it lines up. You see the way it's canted this way? Oops, just nicked my finger now. See how it's canted this way? It allows that belly, look, to come in a straight line. See that? So that's great cutter. So for food prep, it's a full flat grind. I can see that. It's a full flat grind. It is not hollow ground. Nope, not hollow ground. So that's going to be a good slicer while also giving you good strength, good balance there. Nice and tall blade too. So that gives it its specific, you know. And that big old belly, and she was mentioning too about sort of the piercing tip. So looks like it's a decent grind. You can see it's a little uneven, I think, as it gets to the tip there. But otherwise, yeah, I mean, good make. I love the red barrel spacers. You can never be mad about that. Of course, in the words of Zach, lanyard fans rejoice. Look at that. Now that is a well-made knife. Recessed paper pocket clip plus recessed screws. It doesn't seem like it would be that hard to do. This is not an expensive knife. This is a budget knife. Deep pocket clip. I mean, so many much more expensive knives do so much less. Really. I mean, this is a fantastic knife. I mean, this is going to be one of my new favorite little users. And I mean, this is a bug out bag knife because it's not that heavy. And that blade shape is about as utilitarian as it gets. Useful in so many ways. I mean, you could even use this tactically. I mean, lanyard. I think this might be G10 carbon fiber laminate. Wait, no, that's completely clear. As a matter of fact, if I take this scale off, they might have the laminate underneath. I don't know if you can tell, but that's actually see-through, that top there. So once again, if I could, this is clear, completely clear. If I could paint that with glow-in-the-dark paint, I'll once again have a glow-in-the-dark knife, which obviously reduces its tactical qualities. Olha, isso é lumina. Isso. É lumina. I don't know what this strap is for. What is that? Southern Survival. What is that strap for? I'm gonna have to look up what they say about it. So, I mean, you know, I think this was the one where, what's his name? Doc P. I think he got really pissed off. Might have been this one, or might have been after this one. This solo stove, I mean, I don't have one of these. So this, you know, this kind of, this is a good sale. I mean, this kind of makes me want to have one. Get BattleBox. This seems pretty decent to me. I mean, this looks like a pretty good buy. And this is all good stuff. Solo stove, sticker, can't be mad about that. Oh, look at that. Oh, yeah. Entendeu? Entendeu? I mean, talk about survival. What are you going to do without one of these? Isso, sim! Yeah, she's like, wow, this is a bomb-ass giveaway. It's true. So I'm going to have to definitely shout out Video Addict for doing a bomb-ass giveaway. I mean, that guy's really generous. He gave away literally all five of his most recent. And he was kind of sad. There were a couple things. He was like, dang, I'm going to be hurting giving this stuff away. I think it goes like that. Wow, that's pretty simple. Wait, is that really it? Oh my god. Is that really it? No. Can't be. Really? Huh, I guess so. Solo stove light. Look at that. See, it's the light version. So, twigs and other biomass. 8 to 10 minutes. Stainless steel. Cooking ring, directs heat and blocks wind. Secondary burn, hotter fire, less smoke. Oh, I guess you can do two different things. Okay, that's pretty cool. Well, that's more than cool, pretty cool. That's freaking dope. Okay, well, I can get rid of the box. Okay. Então, o mais. One last quick little unboxing of a knife I bought off of In the Pocket. Turns out In the Pocket is actually he's from an area that they high school rival, so he's a local boy. So anyway, that was kind of cool. He was like, oh, I gave him my address. He's like, oh, just really close to you. I'm like, oh, whoa, no way. So he's a homeboy, even though rival homeboy. And I don't mean this as an insult, he did a pretty lousy job he modded the Sheepdog Mini, and this was kind of a grail knife for me. I've been wanting a mini sheepdog for a long time now. I like what he did, but he kind of screwed up a little bit. I mean, in terms of it's a little not clean. Oh my God, that's tiny. Oh my God, it fits about 3.5. He did some sort of a black wash or whatever. It didn't come out that clean. And see, he put it, drilled in a spidey hole, but it didn't come out that clean. I mean, look, the whole thing is not in great shape. $50, I think it's a more than fair price, is what I paid for it. I didn't want to bargain him down. I just went with it. Action's good. Because I wanted a sheepdog, and also by adding in that hole, it is an improvement. So for me, I wasn't worried about reselling this at any point. This is just, for me, is just a keeper. So for me, the aesthetics is less important than the functionality, because I'm just going to keep this. I'm not about the aesthetics of a knife as much, if I'm going to be keeping it. So, I mean, I haven't sold any knives at all anyway, but you know, in the future, if it comes down to it, this will be one of the ones that I just keep regardless. Yeah, so the action's good. I'm glad you didn't do a flipper delete, because that kind of sucks. I like having flippers, although, you know, you always have to make sure it clears the detent, which is a pain. So let's see if that's under 3 inches. Oh gosh, it's well under 3 inches. So that's very legal carry just about anywhere. So I'm really excited about that, which makes me kind of want to get the regular size and the XL. The XL looks hilarious, just to be obnoxious, you know? So I'm excited. There's another new EDC for me. That's definitely going to be an EDC knife for me. Looks like it's right hand. Right hand only. Oh, yeah.
Olha.
É muito pequeno. Oh, yeah. Oops, I forgot my disco lights. No. É não transparente. Oh, yeah. Oh, he put a mirror. He put a mirror polish on that. I don't know if you can tell. It's got a nice even grind. I mean, he must have done that himself. Oh yeah, nice even mirror polish. So yeah, I mean, it's seen some use. I mean, he, you know, probably took a good amount of material off the bottom there. But it's razor sharp, I'm sure. I mean, I don't have anything to find one of these coupons like Jimmy Slash does. Had a million of them laying around. Pretty beat up. Oh, that is stupid sharp. And just so, for the sake of everyone, I just, most people do this wrong. They just kind of go like this. See how it's just going through the same part of the blade? When you're testing paper, you have to do the whole length of the blade. You gotta start here and slowly pull away so that, see, you can demonstrate the sharpness of the entire blade. See? Like that. See? You very rarely see someone doing it all the way. I think the Bush, the DBK guys, I think they do. And they're good at sharpening, you know? So, see? See? You gotta see that? See how I'm going all the way through the length of the blade? Watch. I mean, even what's his name from SMKW, you see him? He just goes through like about that part of the blade. Of the cutting edge. You've got to do, oops, I just did that. You got to, see that? See? I barely cut into it, but I demonstrated that the entire length, it's fine, entire length, see, look. See that? See? I mean, this is a ridiculous edge. He put a sweet edge on that. cannot be mad. I wonder if I cut myself. That was stupid. Okay. Acabou. Tá bom?
Bom. Mostra suas calças.
Isso. Essas
não,
calças.
Você comprou.
Ah, mostra.
Brega.
Não.
Com brega, o meu boyfriend.
Não, brega chique, meu
boyfriend.
Brega chique, boyfriend. Check. Tá.
Depois.
Tá bom. Just talking about the cheesy pants that I got. Oh gosh, I forgot to shout out my sweaters. Anyone wants those sweaters? I got stuck with a shipment. A client bailed out on me.
So,
talking about these. I'd be wearing these every day. So the dollar bill, yo. Fala. Fala. Sim.
As caixas.
Oops.
Então fala pra eles. Opa.
Sim, é a...
fala pra eles.
Yeah, she's saying, tell everyone that I'm finally through all my boxes, which is true. That's it. I'm finally done with all the boxes. This battle box was the last box for me to open. So we are now officially done with all the boxes. I mean, you know, unless... I clean my room and find one laying around here and there, which is kind of shocking to think, like, how do you not notice you haven't opened one of your boxes yet? To be honest, it wouldn't surprise me because I thought there were a couple more things I did order that I don't see, but I'd have to do, like, an extensive inventory to find that out. Anyway. Sério? Yeah, she's saying it took us 2 months. To open all the boxes.
Mas é tudo seu culpa. Todo dia você briga comigo e não grava nunca, né? Quase tudo seu culpa, né? Briga comigo.
Para.
Briga e briga e briga.
Briga. Mas eu te amo. Salva da minha vida. Briga, mas você é o amor da minha vida.
She's so cute. Okay. All right. So that's it for.
No.
Hi
guys. Hi no. Bye.
E mais. Fala inglês. Vai. Fala. Uhum. E o que é outra?
E what? No. No. No.
I'm not crazy.
Stop it. Que you are crazy, Chega. Bye.
Bye. All right, that's it. Freak show's over.